Welcome back, all of you, to this new panel on the external competences and representation of the European Union and its member states in the area of migration and asylum. After having adopted several policy initiatives to tackle the refugee crisis in the last years, the EU and its member states are now doing a huge effort to develop the external dimension of migration. The workshop will be focused on analyzing two key issues in this area: the EU-Turkey statement, in particular in the light of the General Court's orders of last year, and as well the current negotiations of the UN Global Compact on Refugee and Migrations. Both from the perspective of the distribution of external competences and external representation. As Paula Garcia, our convener of this workshop, pointed out in Anne Odysseu's blog published a few days ago, the external dimension of the EU migration policy corresponds to a complex interrelationship of powers between the EU and its member states. The EU-Turkey statement has been subject of much controversy since its adoption. Among the main issues of discussion, two key questions have attracted most of the attention. Diverging views have been expressed as regards the legal nature of the EU-Turkey statement. And secondly, the compatibility of this document with human rights obligations and asylum law has been also a source of discussion. The legal effects and implications of the EU-Turkey statement are to a certain extent a mystery. The speakers have been asked to deal with the following questions. Can the statement be considered a measure not adopted by the EU institutions as it was held by the General Court? Can the collective action of the member states in fields within the scope of the EU or the Union external competences be considered lawful? Current discussions within the UN regarding the adoption of the Global Compact on Refugee and Migration, in which both the Union and its member states are taking part, raise similar issues. It is quite obvious that these instruments will cover areas corresponding to both the EU and its member states' competences. The speakers are going to deal also about the EU representation at the UN negotiations taking place to develop this instrument. We are not just dealing with issues that are interested for lawyers. As you will see, these are relevant issues that will have profound implications in the future. There will be profound implications. There are profound implications for these instruments. To deal with this series of mysteries, we have here a group of eminent and academic experts. Firstly, we have our convener, Paula Garcia Andrade. She's a professor at the Universidad Pontificia Comillas in Madrid. Her research activities focus mainly on the external relations law and migration. She has published several papers in the best journals. She just published an article at the Common Market Law Review a few days ago on this issue, a very long and interesting article. The second speaker will be Professor Thomas Spiekboer. He is a well-known professor on migration at the Vrije University in Amsterdam. He's also a visiting professor at Lund. He was recently appointed as member of the Holland Society of Science and Humanities. He has led some of the most interesting research projects in migration in Europe in the last years. As a result of these projects, he has published several books and articles in the best journals, as you can see in the summary included in the CVs. And the following speaker will be Sonja Bolaer. She has an amazing practical experience. She has worked as a lawyer for the Criminal Tribunal for the former Yugoslavia and also for Rwanda. He has advised several international organizations. And in 2004, she joined the European Union institutions, where now she is a senior legal advisor with the Council of with the Council of the European Union. Finally, our third speaker will be Mauro Gatti. He is a promising young academic. He is working now at the University of Luxembourg. Even though he is very young, he has done an amazing career publishing very good papers and also an interesting book as a result of his thesis. And finally, our rapporteur will be Professor Philippe de Brucker. All of you know by now Professor de Brucker. He is a professor here at this university. He has been leading one of the most important groups on migration. As a result of that, he established the Odysseus Network. Thanks to him and this network, you are here today. Apart from that, he has been involved in many different projects. He worked also in the past for the Commission, developing legislative initiatives. I don't want to devote more time to present the speakers. It's better if you listen to them.